Welcome back everyone to Let's Play Panzer General 2 in what appears to be the final Red Army campaign operation in Seelow Heights. I mentioned Seelow, pronounced it wrong of course. It's actually Seelow Heights. Of course Heights is designation in English, so I don't know what it actually means in German, but yeah. So it's going to be the last leg of journey for this Red Army crew or corps and General Masaryk, as you can see right here. In his dossier, probably kept by the NKVD or Stavka. Now, lined with a pretty impressive string of brilliant victories, some of them were rather difficult to achieve, such as in Kanyev and Leningrad. But the rest was, well, I guess Prokhorovka also was rather dicey in certain respects, but the rest of that, especially the last mission in Finland, Vipuri to be exact, now Vyborg in Russian Federation, and the first mission, Saturn on the Chir, along the Chir River, where the Russians attacked the Romanians, were rather easygoing, and I guess it is setting up for an ultimate conclusion of the General Masaryk's career. Perhaps he might have a career after this, but his fighting days are going to be over if he succeeds in defeating the Germans at Seelow Heights. It opens the way for either, you know, Zhukov or Konev, who are racing with each other. To take Berlin. So we are going to be, I think, advancing from Liber Oder. By the way, there's actually one more space for a medal, be it gold, silver, or bronze. So you can definitely see that the space even here provides that General Masaryk's operation here is going to be his final one. Yeah, so brilliant victory, 5 brilliant victories, and I didn't really lose a lot of units. In the last mission, I did lose some strength on the tank unit, but didn't really lose a single one, even though I was surprised that one of the tanks there were, I think, yeah, the leader tank was actually surprised by the Finnish infantry, but it was able to survive that, fortunately. And yeah, so the casualty inflicted and taken, as you can see the numbers. So, Seelow Heights is actually your last remaining natural defense just outside of Berlin, around 90 kilometers or so, which is less than 60 miles out, and the Russians now had to cross River Oder, and now River Oder is a natural border between Poland and Germany, so Berlin is rather close to Poland right now, if you can sort of extrapolate the information. Back then it was all part of East Prussia, I believe, and as the war concluded, Soviet Union, while taking some of the, I guess, substantial amount of Polish lands for themselves, they have sort of compensated the loss of Polish territory by basically attacking on the East Prussian territories onto Poland. So that's how the victors have negotiated and came upon a decision. Of course, the Germans, I imagine, was rather not happy about the outcome, but that's what it is right now. That's how things are, how things shook down, I guess, at the conclusion of the war. Anyways, so Seelow Heights is where I think Zhukov, General Zhukov, made the last dash across River Oder by constructing a multitude of bridges, get the bridgehead going. And yeah, it was basically natural defense. They had a little bit of ridge there, the sort of a higher ground where the defenders would be able to command the view down onto the River Oder, and then the space between the river and the ridge itself was kind of swampy with a lot of streams and little tributaries that made crossing it rather difficult. And of course the Germans constructed defensive lines, I think around 2, each of which was 15 miles deep approximately, so it was really hard for them to actually, the Russians, to be able to crack that defense. But the Russians had air superiority for the most part, and they had humongous amount of artilleries, like 200 per each mile or something. It's just crazy amount of concentration of firepower that the Russians brought. So when the Russians attacked across River Oder, the defender of the Seelow Heights, which I believe to be was Gotthard Heinrichi, he was a defensive specialist, and he was basically handpicked for the role of defending that particular very decisive juncture, or the point where they could defend the capital. And he probably thought that, you know, he probably knew, I don't know how, but he knew when the Russians were going to attack, which is the thing was dawn hours of April 16th. And he is able to pull his troops back to the main defensive lines on the ridge. And the Russians, when they pulverized what they thought were the initial German lines, it was basically mostly empty. And yeah, I mean, Heinrich was able to pull that off. And Zhukov, after that, had a bit of trouble trying to take the ridge, and you know, had to report to Stalin, of course, that you know he was facing some difficulties. But on the whole, I mean, the sheer difference in materials and men won out. Basically, it was only a matter of time before the Russians were able to overrun, because the difference was just huge. Like 2.5 million soldiers concentrated, facing up against a bit of a motley crew of a remnants of like 9th Army, 4th Army, kind of grouped together into Army Group Vistula. Also had some problems with defending the flank toward the Seelow Heights. The north, I think General Rokossovsky, I think he's Polish, but was a very well-known general as well in the Red Army, was attacking with his army. And also in the south, there was Konev, basically racing with Zhukov at the behest of Stalin toward Berlin to get the glory, so to speak, of capturing the capital. Yeah, so a lot of things happened leading up to Seelow Heights. Of course, we skipped from Finland, Operation Bagration, and also the very important but less well-known Lvov Sandomierz operation that led the Red Army to almost clear up the Army Group Center and isolate the Army Group North into like Courland Peninsula and just go right up against the German capital on the River Oder. And they were really close to meeting the Americans as well, who I think by first week of April had to bear the news of Roosevelt passing. He died before Germany could capitulate. Yeah, but they're steadfastly squeezing Germany into two pieces, cutting them in half around the River Oder. If you have seen my LP, that happened near, I think, Dessau. I don't know whether that river was actually Oder, something else, I think. I think it was called Elbe, the River Elbe, where they met. There are a lot of rivers in Germany. So yeah, Russians are doing each part to clear up the German capital and I guess into Viper's Nest, so to speak. The Nazis were fleeing, and but Hitler, for some reason, after he had conducted the war to its disastrous conclusion, I mean, he sent two of the most elite Panzer units down south, as you also could have seen in the episode where I had to liberate Budapest from the Soviet Union. I think that was called Operation Conrad. That's where Hitler thought that the main thrust of the Russian offensive is going to take. And that's basically wrong. I think maybe the Russians were trying to trick the Germans into thinking that the main offensive is going to be there. But 2.5 million men with like thousands of tanks and hundreds of thousands of guns were trained right across the River Oder into Seelow Heights right now. And that's where Masaryk and his army is basically going and is going to be a part of. You can see the tanks right here. Yeah, definitely I have named them. So some of the tanks have gained a lot of experience by now, gained a new tank model. As you can see, as I scroll down, the artillery strength is very weak, of course, but I do suspect that I'm going to get some extra artillery as part of that, you know, huge amount of guns that were present. Yeah, I do have two recon, but I might want to add one more just in case. The air defense has worked rather well in Finland, so I think three is a pretty adequate number to defend against the presence of the German Luftwaffe. They didn't really have a lot of aircraft. I think they were able to muster up some substantial number of air power during the early part of 1945. I don't know what happened after that, but there is not really a mention of them having been a factor. So even though they're present, air presence would not be more of a hindrance to the Soviet Union. Maybe they had more trouble in the early going because the road was basically jam-packed with materials and logjam was able to provide easy targets. And of course, it was kind of muddy too. I mean, swampy areas where they had to cross. Infantry, and of course, these regulars, now neglected, are very due for an upgrade. And there was a comment by viewer, MAM162, that suggested I bring some engineers along. So I just do that. Convert them or upgrade them to breaching engineers. See if I could make use of them with the tanks. And of course, I have to make a decision here as well with the Yak 9s. Gaining experience, you know, they're not to trifle with, especially in the early goings before the Luftwaffe gets going. And I did bring another Yak here to bolster my forces or chances against the Finnish air power, and I was able to do that. And then you also have to gain some experience, mainly due to my mistake of using this instead of amassing experience points for Yak 9. I think this one is almost at the cusp of another. Well, not really. I was hoping for it to be a bit closer to the 2-bar experience, but yeah, I mean, a bit of strafing will do, and maybe even get a leader for us. Anyways, yes, let's go up to the upgrade unit portion. Going to be the bulk of what I'm going to spend on this particular phase, preparing my forces. This KV-85 without any designation. Well, it does have designation here, Street Fighter. Well, I need to upgrade some of these tanks, at least one liter tank to an IS-3, because I do hear a report, well, specifically from Piano 6888, that there will be some advanced tanks. And here's the Cirque mentioned that the Germans have now free reign of technology or whatever the units that they have at disposal, so they can just purchase, just like they did at Prokhorovka, any unit that they desire, so that's going to be problematic. I'm going to counter that with as many IS-3s and IS-2s as possible, but I have to first, let's just try to upgrade these regulars before it is too late. So breaching it is with truck. The upgrading these guys do, yeah, I mean it doesn't cost that much. So let's do that. Yeah, now they're all prepared and organic transport is available, and I want to upgrade one guard cavalry into engineer as well. Just in case. Yeah, 180. Yeah, okay. Just to maximize my chances against the entrenched fortresses and units that there surely be there. The Germans made every village and defensible point into festung or something, which is fortress. And let's go back to the tanks. Okay, so this tank is rather experienced. 4-bar experience, and this is the Street Fighter, and this is, I think, aggressive attack. Some of these guys have to keep using KV-85 because I particularly like their ammo capacity. I was thinking about kind of side grading them into 34-85, but I just like the variety, and just these two tanks really do not offer that kind of a difference for it to matter. Matter in the end, so yeah, just have to upgrade these guys into IS-3s and 2s. Let's see how much of a difference. Yeah, it's number of difference. Maybe I like to get this guy into IS-2. Oh, let's just check how much it costs to upgrade IS-2 to IS-3 first. Oh my goodness, 388. Wow, it's basically purchasing T-34-85, so I probably will have to leave this IS-2 alone and then try to upgrade these guys, basically. Wow. Yeah, so I have to make a decision whether to actually purchase new T-34-85s or upgrade the existing tanks to IS-3s. But, you know, as you can see, the experienced ones do offer the most efficiency in their attack, so yeah, there's no question that they'll be more valuable and more useful in the upgraded form. So yeah, I upgrade this to IS-3s. I like to upgrade the Street Fighter one as well. Or should I go for overwhelming attack guy, which is this guy, OM. I don't know why I named him OM, it's supposed to be OA. At least start with O so I know what unit I'm talking about. Not this guy, but the 84 guy. How much does it cost to upgrade? 384, not much. Wow, why does this guy have so much? Oh, maybe because this is still over strength. Alright, yeah. So it doesn't really have that much of a difference upgrading between these two to IS-3s. Overwhelming attack is pretty good because it converts suppressed unit into damage unit, so you can definitely see where this tank is able to just overrun the infantry. Well, not overrun it, but destroy a full-strength infantry outright if the dice rolls each way, just a little bit to each favor. So I upgrade this guy To IS3. Yeah, I think two IS3s, one IS2. I think good enough. Alright, so only thing left here is whether to bring in more artillery or to upgrade the existing units. Also, I already mentioned that I expect some artillery units that are experienced, at least, you know, 2 bars experienced, to join us for the last bit of push. And we have gained some new units in terms of fighters and tactical bombers. How much does this cost? LA-7, well, is the, I guess, next. Yeah, it's a definite upgrade over Yak-9. So I have no choice but upgrade these guys. And the IL-2M3 has, yeah, its upgrade cost is now superseding the available prestige, which is too bad. I can get this guy, reassign this guy, and provide enough points for upgrading one of these to IL-10. But should I want that? Would that be more effective to... So it has 28 experience points, so... Yeah, I think I reassigned this guy, although it does have some experience. I do know how to use these air force, however slight or minuscule they are, to its intended purpose, which is basically hit and run attacks. And I did use them to a pretty, you know, good efficiency, especially in the Finland mission, as I was trying to clear up the last remaining defenders. And if I am lacking for any more of a... If I do feel that there should be a bit more protection or air presence, then I can bring in another Yak-9 without any losses in terms of experience points, because the reassigned one didn't really have a lot of experience. Alright, so, yeah. Upgrade this to IL-10. Looks the same, but apparently it's more advanced, and as you can see here, it does have a more protection, so... I guess it does make a bit of a difference, as it can at least survive one turn against advanced German Luftwaffe even without an escort, because it does have difference in terms of air attack. Yep. So it's going to give the German pilot second thought. I mean, if they mistakenly attack it just because they thought it was IL-2, there would be a rude surprise, a rude awakening. It does give away a bit against anti-infantry, so I do bring IL-2s just in case. I don't know whether that's going to make any difference, but in terms of overall unit, yeah, IL-10 is definitely better. I think the Russians had similar idea to just bolster the defenses to the existing very effective IL-2s in order to make it a bit more lethal, as it had to fly low. Consider a tank in the air or something. I do consider them a bit more of an air artillery, but, you know, it doesn't make any difference. If I had more... How much do I have? 392. Okay. I didn't want to bring one more anti-tank if I had enough prestige, but unfortunately I can't. It would have been pretty nice to bring some of these guys, because they might have served as an impromptu self-propeller artillery, because the Russians have none of those, except for Katyusha rockets. And to say that Katyusha rocket is an artillery is a bit of a misnomer, because it wasn't really that accurate. It was kind of a unit where you can supply wide barrage of destruction or suppression. But in terms of accurately targeting a unit, I don't think this was actually used for that purpose. Yeah, well, I needed accuracy and I needed power. So bringing this guy would have been pretty good. But as you can see in the last mission, to bring in new units of this stature, investing this amount of prestige is not really advisable, because, you know, apparently the Germans have a whole lot of experienced units guarding the capital, of course. And almost every one of my units here are experienced, except for this guy, but it's on the cusp of being experienced. Yeah, 66. Well, not really, but I did bring the unit in the last mission, so... Yeah, after one particular SU, I think 85, was destroyed in Leningrad, I just brought another one. The recon, I don't know if I should bring on the recon. I just want to overstrengthen the existing guys here. Let's basically give them all ones first, and then see if I have enough to give the leaders a bit more in the end, if I have enough pool of prestige. The air force, I just leave it be, because I'm not going to use them a whole lot. 92 left. Okay, let's give us the aggressive attack guy one more, and overwhelming attack guy another one. Do I have enough to give us another one? Nope. That's it. Alright, so this is it, folks. This is the army that's going to bring the Red Army into Seelow Heights. And I don't know what's going to happen. Hopefully I'm going to make a pretty good headway in the first few missions, or first few turns, and see what happens. Okay. Let's see if I have any extra units. Okay, so it doesn't reveal anything here. It's a bit ominous sign. But anywho, let's go into it. Yeah, and you can see there's a whole lot of infantry and artillery supporting us. So that's good. I mean, in the flank, I think. So bringing victory 10 turns. Apparently, yeah. I guess the battle itself of Seelow Heights didn't really take a long time. I don't think it even took a week for the Red Army to overcome the defenses there. The battle was known to be particularly difficult just because I think Zhukov thought that he would just roll over everything and then was met with some fierce resistance. But then in the scheme of things, it was just a prelude to a Battle of Berlin, and yeah, it didn't take as long a time as I expected given the number of casualties and destruction that was left in its wake. And I guess they were racing Zhukov and Konev. And the Battle of Berlin itself really didn't take a long time either, because this is April 14th, not 16th, so I was wrong there. April, from the end of April to the first or the second week of May was where the battle was the fiercest, I think. Or was it just the first week of May? And it was over. The Battle of Britain was over. No, Battle of Britain, sorry. Battle of Berlin was over in the first or second week of May 1945. So yeah, I mean, this is basically right up against conclusion of the war. Alright, so I get an extra tank as well. My goodness, why do they feel so generous all of a sudden? Let's go to the strategic map, and wow, yeah. Oh wow, as you could have guessed it, Berlin is right here, so it's around 90 kilometers from here to here, River Oder, yeah. And there's also River Nies or something where there was a army, I think it was first Ukrainian, under General Konev. One airfield. They have multiple airfields, I think. No, there's one and another one probably here. Yeah, another one, their aerodrome. Spree River, river that crosses into Berlin. Spreenhagen, yeah, makes sense. It's in the river Spree. Okay, so I guess I need to divide my troops once again into two prongs. And treble, make one treble down the south, another treble along this road, while this infantry is going to crawl up on this bridgehead and then try to either cross into the north, supporting our flank, or just try to follow us, and then it's going to create a huge logjam because there's a hill here that's going to impede a lot of progress. But I do have breaching guys, so where can I use my breaching guys? I can use them to either basically cross here, you know, getting another bridge here to the last two objectives. Yeah, and then I can use another one here to facilitate the movement of men and material across this silo. Yeah, this is basically the hill where all the defensive arrangements were made, and this is where I expect the most fighting is going to take place. Okay, so one breaching guy is going to follow this group, of course, and maybe I'm going to put other guys here. All the breaching guys here. Yeah, it's all hill. So, I mean, even if there's breaching, making a, you know, one extra pathway, I think it would actually help though. Yeah, definitely would help. So I bring on the breach guy here, but there's a lot of artillery, so yeah, I mean, I had to make a pretty big rush in order for that to be effective. All right, let's just try to, get these guys going. Street Fighter. Let's put it right across, and IS-3, one IS-3 here, one IS-3 down there. Oh, I have yet to cross. Oh, Frankfurt. Frankfurt was, I think it was actually a fortress. I'm not so sure, but yeah, I think it was actually a fortress, and it was a very, very big city indeed. Here it doesn't really seem big, but I think it was a pretty substantial city that was converted into a festung or something, if you will. So I guess I just keep this artillery here because I suspect that there will be definitely a fortress. And SF is going to go here against the fortress. Yeah, okay. And some engineers. Need to be here. Breaching guy. Yeah, breaching guy. I think this is breaching guy without the knife or what is it called? Blade or something attached to it. These are all guards. Wow. These are pretty powerful units. I don't know how much of experience they have, but yeah, very nice. Obviously didn't expect that many reinforcements to come along. Okay, so resilience guy is going to of course go up against the Seelow Heights overwhelming attack. Okay, there's another Masaryk is going to... Yeah, it's going to be good for Masaryk to race across. Wow, I gave him 13. Oh, and this was already over strength. That's why it would cost so much to upgrade to IS-3s. There was definitely a difference there. So IS-3 here. And aggressive attack guy. Well, should I put this guy here? Do I have any other? So two leaders down there. And yeah, two leaders down there. So which way should the remaining leader go or be deployed? I mean, you know, this is Seelow Heights and that's where the most amount of defense was congregated. So I'm going to give this guy deployment in the north, another heavily overstrength tank. And the rest of it is, I still have a lot of KV-85s and 3485s. Yeah, fortunately not overstrength. So these guys will, yeah, so four tanks. Give them 5 tanks. And I'm going to give this guy... Alright, so this is hill, but getting out of the hill doesn't really negatively affect the mobility, right? Or does it matter? Yeah, I just give him this overlooking hill. Maybe he's going to be able to just get out pretty quickly. Yep. And then the air force, air defense, excuse me. Air defense, a good air defense here. One air defense right here. And remaining tank, they have 6 tanks compared to 4, okay, compared to 5. What should I do? How many experience points does this guy have? Can I check now? No, maybe not. I give this guy, let me just check right now how many of the units that I have deployed. Okay, so if I find something's very well protected here, some of these guys can go down here to reinforce or to help the siege. Yeah, so going up against the Seelow Heights where there will be a lot of artillery and fortresses entrenched, it's going to take the most amount of effort. So yeah, I'm going to give this guy a deployment here up in the north. Hope I made the right decision. Yeah, another defense here, and then the rest of it is going to join this brethren in supporting the siege of Seelow Heights. Of course, some of them will join these guys kind of away from the front because I'm afraid that there will be artillery. Okay, so breaching, one breaching here and one other breaching right here, and it's going to displace as fast as possible. And this guy as well. Not a lot of space now allocated for deployment, especially on the front. And of course the air force is going to make the first turn. They're going to try to dent the German defenses in the first turn before the Luftwaffe gets noticed and takes to the air. Alright, let's exit deployment. And wow, you can see this. Oh my goodness, there's a lot of fortress here. But it has to be taken, and man. 4 and 8, so they're kind of weak against tanks though, so I guess that's kind of relief. And we have engineers, and I can make use of the, now of course, the bombers. Alright, so let's start from the north and spot for both of these guys. Okay, so we have a Panther sighting. I'm sure this is Panther G, yep, and 3 experience. Wow. Alright, let's just travel one more hex. And you can reveal an artillery, which is not that strong. Alright, so we have a heavily entrenched regulars and Bolkstrom, of course, makes appearance. Yeah, most of them are kind of scarred from the police force, and a man of, I guess, advanced age pressed into service under the party direction. And another Panther G, so, wow. Yeah, this is going to be a battle, firefight. Yeah, have to make them weak first. Okay, so where is that? Oh, wow, it's the Air Force is right there. Yeah, this is the final mission, so I'm gonna throw everything. Do they have anti-air? Cheering drill, didn't really work. Oh wow, alright. Alright, one of my bombers might get killed. One, alright, so at least we're able to damage one. It's not going to matter though. Alright, so my job here is to just smash through the German defenses. Let's try with IS-2s first. I think I can overrun some of the odd fortress or two. 0 and 5. Okay, so IS-2, is it entrenched? Yes, low amount of entrenchment. Okay. KV-85s. Okay, why don't I just use my weaker units? Well, not really weak, but... yeah, resilient guy. Wow, the defense here is staggering, huh? Okay. Because overstrengthened probably. And you destroyed my tank, my goodness. Yeah, that's not good. IS-3s, okay. They have to... yeah, this guy will need to... yeah. How about this guy? Yeah, going to be expanding my bridgehead somewhat here. And target this Panther G. Thankfully, maybe it was suppressed to a tune of only one unit, but still it's going to help me to get the pretty good... 3 and 4, wow, okay. I mean, no damage here, and then I'm able to bring further units to bear upon these guys. Okay, so let's try to... the resilient guys, or is it aggressive attack? Yeah, this is final mission, so I can throw everything I have into the foray, but I do want to conserve some of the units because you cannot really expect what is going to happen. So resilience guy is going to be pretty useful because, I mean, you know, it does have a 16 and 14 defense against the air units, and it's comparable. But then I do want the most amount of punch. So let's see if I can shoot across. Oh wow, okay, let's try that. Okay. Nice, destroyed. But of course had to sacrifice. But yeah, that is definitely more than I expected in the engagement with Panther G. I can definitely feel that my tank army is doing its job very well. ISU is going to be limited here, but it can definitely take a pot shot at the infantry, the regular guy who's entrenched across the on the hill overlooking. Yeah, overlooking this particular field where I'm sure that the Red Army had a lot of trouble in traversing because of the entire, you know, attack that has been focused upon this particular bridgehead. I do... yeah, I mean, I don't know why, but these guys... where's my breaching guys? They might help. Breaching guys... oh, actually, can I go into the... oh, okay. Oh, this guy... yeah, these guys... wow, is it impassable or something, or... oh my, okay, so these guys will have to just creep along the river. Well, I mean, it doesn't really make any difference in the big scheme of things because they'll in no time, you know, have to not only navigate the stream, but also kind of straddled on both sides with this rough terrain, like hills. So yeah, these guys will need to actually get out of this place as quick as possible, maybe even go down, or I don't know, like these guys have a lot of problem in getting out of the bridgehead. I leave one just in case this guy needs a fire support, and 3 experienced artillery, very good, very nice. So I have one more tank, No, I have 3 more tanks, wow. But some of them are not be able to reach. One, okay. Resilient. I guess you. Yeah, use a tank in order to disrupt the defense. 4 and 4, nice. Can this IS do something now? No, can't do anything. It is definitely a possibility that this Panther is going to go down here and try to hit us. So I guess this ISU might be able to help us in taking that, protecting that road. And can I actually overrun this guy? Well, infantry has to now follow us. Let's do that first. Is there any infantry here? I don't know. I have no idea. So I just keep safe the first few turns at least. And this bridging guy, well, the bridging guy, well, I already made a decision to, yeah, just move them. So, all right, no biggie. The experienced one is going to be this one. I should have named it or something. They named it 26mm instead of 25. This guy will just, maybe, yeah, maybe he can cross. I can forward over this older river. Surprising. Okay, so the biggest question now is whether I can make it work here. 0 and 8. Sure. Nice. Okay, so this guy will be, yeah, going straight into this resilient guy, but it's resilient, so he might be able to survive or at least get suppressed without any other threat or forthcoming threat of being surrounded. So on the whole, yeah, I'm pretty happy with how that turned out. Okay, here is going to be a bit, yeah, pretty sticky as well. I should have brought my AI-3 up there because I didn't really expect the Panther Gs to be stationed. But, you know, I had to live with it. And, let's just try to attack directly. Two bridges to make use of. I wonder why the Germans didn't destroy it entirely. Well, it's good for us, I guess. Engineer is going to definitely help, but I need to check with the artillery whether there is maybe artillery afoot. And this is really useful because the street fighter, so it basically ignores entrenchment. So I'm going to make sure that I... Wow. Yeah, let's do that then. Yeah, there's artillery. Artillery check. And this guy will clear up the road or the fortresses. 0 and 6, 0 and 6. Okay, so entrenchment does make a difference, as you could have seen. If it was being attacked by a normal KV-85, it might not be able to damage it a lot, especially when it's entrenched to tune of 8. But this street fighter is able to just, you know, target it as if there was no entrenchment in the city. Very useful in that respect. There's essentially only one artillery. Okay, so I can not cross yet, but I can definitely use the 85s to overrun another fortress, which is good. And more, yeah, more soldiers hiding in the wings. Wow, yeah, surprising. Not really surprising. Alright, so I need to damage this guy, who is still stripping, very hardened SS unit. Man, yeah, I mean, I could have brought... Yeah, do not regret my decision to bring IS-3 here now because of all the entrenched units in the forest. And I'm going to lose out here, except for here, for some reason. Yeah. KV-85 is not going to enter. Don't see our artillery unit. But maybe I should use that to check whether there is artillery. Yeah. Bridging guy. Oh, there's bridging. So I can make use of the bridge here. And maybe send my recon. Yeah, send a recon. No, I can't. Ah, too bad. Because there's a zone of control, some unit here. Oh, I guess the fortress does make a difference. Wow. Alright. There's an artillery here nearby? Nope, I don't see it. Oh! Outright destruction. Now my recon can move. Nice! Is there... Oh my god, what is this? King Tiger. K/K. What does it mean? King of Kings or something? Yeah, there is definitely a... Definitely a danger afoot. And yeah, my AC is going to get it. Oh my goodness, dear me. Oh my god. But yeah, my little attempt to cross worked, and maybe I'm going to apply some pressure with this T-34s. I don't know whether there's going to be any effective. Yeah, but there's definitely artillery in range now. Oh man, yeah, my IS-3s have to now maybe travel as quick as possible to the middle. Should I do that? Maybe I should do it, yeah, okay. This has a range of 4. Damn it. Yeah, it's going to be in the range. Outside the range here, nice. My IS-3 is going to go up here just in case something bad happens to that ISU. He can definitely come back and then destroy this. And yeah, do we just stay here? Yeah, just in the first few turns. Okay, it's under their protection, so that's good. I'm gonna leave that. Oh man, so this guy, yeah, it's going to take a bit of a shortcut. Yeah, alright. So I guess this is a narrow part of the river where they can cross, make crossing. This guy will just stay put, and this guy, San Francisco. The Street Fighter. Anyways, yeah, I'm going to maybe pull back. I don't want to get swamped by all these units. But it's going to be protected by the ample shells of this artillery. So yeah, I don't think I'm in trouble. Yeah, fire support is there, it's not in the city environs. Okay, first turn is over, folks. I was able to destroy Panther G, a very threatening unit, and was basically pending a huge firefight with at least the King Tiger. Now, I hope it gets a prize or something. Probably not. It's going to come either this way or this way in order to threaten our flank. Pretty scary. Air Force has been deployed right away just to gain a bit of leverage against the Panther G's, a very, very impressive tank, probably the best tank in the game. King Tiger, unfortunately, is not able to move that far, right? Only 4, yeah, it's basically on the level of, I guess it's a bit better, on the level of IS-3, a bit better than IS-3, in fact, in terms of the sheer power. But only 2 experience, so let's see what happens. 10 turns, I cannot believe it. Wow. Wow, okay, so there's another artillery here. Thankfully, it wasn't that damaged. Yep, so the... Okay, uh-oh. Huh. Nice, nice. Okay, so that's good. Oh boy. Oh my goodness, my guy is going to be killed, yep. Oh my goodness, survived, but he's going to get killed. Oh my goodness, still survives. Resilient, very... Oh my goodness, this guy. Wow, face up against Panther G, King Tiger, and a regular, experienced regular was able to survive because of the resilience. But now he's in trouble. Oh my goodness, I don't know. I don't know if I should say he's lucky or basically born with a red star above his head or something. Yeah, I mean that was something else. My goodness. Need to find a way for this guy to run away as far as possible from the prying eyes, but let's just try to attack with the Air Force. Saving Private Resilience, Maechich. For some reason, I wasn't able to find the Russian analog to the name Maechich. Basically think that the closest form, I guess, to that name is a Russian term for boy. I don't know whether that is actually accurate or correct. Start from the north. Definitely thought that Maechich is going to be destroyed. And have to spend a minute to say a eulogy in his honor or something. Another artillery, okay. Okay, good. Now, crossing here. This guy can maybe move or something. Nowhere to turn. Okay. Yeah. This guy. Oh boy. Alright. 22. Okay. I have to make that count. Let's attack with the Air Force. The most experienced one. 0-1. Okay. Oh, suppressed. Okay. 0-2. Not bad. Alright, so who's willing to overrun this guy? Nobody. Oh! Nice! This is great! Aggressive attack guy. Dang, this is very impressive. Now, can this guy get out? Yes, he can. Oh my god. Protected. Personal protection by one of these anti-air. Hopefully it's going to be enough. Speaking of air defense, let's damage this guy. Joins 3, alright. It's okay. It's tempting, but my foremost need right now is to take this Frankfurt. Oh, that sucks. Join 0-1-1. Okay, the Street Fighter guy will have to do something about it. This guy. Yeah, there's an artillery here, so I need to take care of it. In the long run. 1-7. Okay. Wow. Nice, nice. Very good. Wow, didn't lose out at all. It's very impressive. Alright. Wow. Alright. Just getting this guy out. Another artillery. They're filled with artilleries, folks. Artillery heaven. Artillery hog heaven. And even if I capture this point, yeah, it's going to be taken by the Nazis in no time because of the artillery that is basically poised to attack whoever is going to take it, daring us. So I have to basically fight them head on now. Alright, okay. Not a bad result, but it could be better. Yeah, it's outside of the range here, I think. This can damage. Yeah, this is actually. This does have entire Frankfurt proper entrench range, so. If I destroy this, maybe I'll be able to move, or getting into the city does take a bit of movement point. KB-85 against the Sturmtruppen. With the defense, it's not that good. It does have a better defense, close defense than the. Well, it does have a same. Okay. Got it wrong. Yes, okay, I can take it. But I'm going to win the city, so just attack this fortress. Let's open up the way. 7-2. Okay, wasn't able to destroy. Yeah, everything is 4. It's going to win the range. I really need to destroy the artillery. I don't want to get my infantry languishing in the other side of the order for too long. I mean, my bridging guys are already there. Yeah, this guy will be in the range. Yeah, nowhere to run, nowhere to. Just have to stay here. Wow. Yeah, and then I let these guys attack and then support my tanks here. And the next turn, I definitely have to make roadway to these two. I mean, I can probably just swing around. My recon might help. Oh, there's another one, yeah, so I have to basically swing around and overwhelm the forces. I don't know how I'm going to do that, but Street Fighter is going to definitely help. And use whatever armor that I have here to... These guys are damaged enough, or because of due to the close fire support. Then, yeah, I have to use the armor in order to maximize the damage. But, I don't know, things can change here, depending on what I can do. Especially here. This has already entered, yeah. Okay, IS-2's definitely can overrun. Well, not overrun, but can make things very difficult for this guy. 1 and 4, yeah, let's damage it. 3 and 1 is suppressed. Yeah, it's blocked. It's blocked, okay. 1 and 5, let's push this guy out as well. 8 and 2, yeah, definitely do that. And can I make it? Yes, I can. So I can overrun this guy. It's going to mean the hill, but it's going to also bring us... If you check here, yeah, it's basically going to be on the hill, so I have to make a detour or, you know, meet the open field and then just cross right into Berlin. There's also a way to do it, I think. I can probably split up my forces once again, try to achieve that. Yeah, so with IS-2, I will make sure I destroy this guy on the hill. Nice, okay. And skip around, yeah, just clearing the space. Well, I have one shell left, I have to also be mindful of that. It's really, yeah, it's really, you just have to be on the top of your game or something if you're using all these different types of tanks. And the IS-3s are definitely sandwiched these guys. 1 and 6, okay, so no worries there. Wow, 2 artilleries, huh? 6 and 3, and prime for catch and release. Well, I don't know, so capture and destroy, not catch and release. I don't want to release these guys at all, and yeah, good, good. So King Tiger's no more. My resilient tank is kind of avenged. You know, I'm not dead yet. Still have some life left. Guards will... Yeah, these guys remove. This guy's also move. And I want to take a peek on what is happening. Maybe I can come back because of the road. Yeah, there's nothing happening here, thankfully. Okay, so I don't want to go into forest per se. I want to maybe support these guys to clear up the rest of the... Wow. Only have one shell left, so make it count. I don't want to be on the range of two artilleries. 5 and 5, I can probably overrun it. Cannot overrun it. Okay, maybe my ISU can help. Yeah, my ISU can... Nope. Cannot do anything. Oh, wow. Nice. I didn't know that they can fire over the hill. I mean, this is more or less an artillery, so... Yeah, good, good. Okay. Where should I park this guy? Maybe I should add to the strength of this group, this armor group, and then park this guy right over here. 0 and 4. Alright, yeah. Okay, so target this guy now? Yeah, I can. Well met there, the bridging guys, well... Oh, they can destroy? Okay, good. Of course. The air defense is going to follow... Yeah, this group. That's good, and... Right here. No, one of them... Yeah, one of it has to defend the stricken tank. Hope they don't really guess correctly where that tank is. I hope they're just busy themselves in trying to get all the dangers salient right now for me. They're the best case right now for my tank. Resilient tank. Going to be fixed up pretty quickly, hopefully. Can this guy move one more Oh, there's artillery. Yep, I see it. I see it very well. Yeah, the same 4-range gun. I wonder whether they have a K-18 or something. It is definitely possible. They can bring King Tigers and Panther Gs. I say why not? I mean, they have enough prestige stored up for that final defense of their city. Alright, engineers. Yeah, this will be very important later on. This guy will be out of the range. Alright, so that's good. Yeah. What is happening down there? No, what is happening up here? Two artilleries? Yes, okay. I wonder why they didn't put enough artilleries where it actually mattered at Seelow. Apparently they didn't. They have 88? Yes. I don't know how he revealed it, or maybe the recon did. But I need to get out of the city. really tempted to take this, but I also am tempted to make, you know, cajole this guy into taking Frankfurt once again so I can overrun in the next turn. That's my plan. I don't know whether it's going to work, but work well so far. This guy will definitely protect. Alright, so I was able to destroy the bulk of German armor presence in the Seelow Heights or Seelow Ridge. I'm pretty happy with how the IS-3s are doing, but one of them is out of ammo, so need to spend a turn. But this guy is also joining the foray, and maybe we'll go down once again and help with the artilleries here. 8, 9 turns, okay. Yeah, they got it. I was able to cajole them. Oh, this flag is moving for some reason. Okay. Yeah, the armor is not really that useful. Okay, I was able to destroy one. Oh, here we go. Here we go. Yeah, that sucks. Okay, one of them is gone. Did his job though, so... Wow, okay. Yeah, they definitely targeted my bomber there. Alright, so... Can I... Yeah, overrun. Has to be overrun. Nice. The killing a bit of a... Oh! Nice, very nice. Okay, so SF works in many different ways. Alright, so let's check. They still have the Stoßtruppen blocking our access to swing around. But maybe this guy can swing around. Yeah, I think so. He's going to be in the forest though. How many ammo? Oh, has nothing. Okay, so infantry can advance finally. But I think there's another... I have to check. Yeah, there's another artillery. Yeah, of course. So... many of the... Yeah, it still has plenty and it's able to target. Here I can make sure... Yeah, here I can open the space up a bit to make sure that I can get enough space for the engineers to capture, destroy this point. And my 34 is able to attack the artillery. Okay, so let's make this count, folks. Let's make this count. Okay, so 1 and 6 once again. 73 even better, and destroyed! Wow, this guy is definitely proving its worth, especially against artilleries, for some reason. And out of shell. Alright, so you've done your job. And the rest of the tanks maybe can help us. Okay, so clear and heal. Can this guy travel? 1 and 1. 1 and 7. 6 and 4 destroyed? Nope. Okay, too bad. But this guy, can you shoot? Yeah, let's attack the city first. Nine and one. Wow. Wow. Nice. Okay. So can I attack one more? No, I can't. But very, very impressive, to say the least. And now the engineers can make, yeah, they can make an advance now. And destroy this fortress or something. They can't, okay. But they can now make a move. And this guy has nothing. Unless there is another artillery here, then, ha, huh, goodness. That is going to be pretty bad. Yeah, but my artillery is, oops. Oh, okay, destroyed. Okay, that's good. Oh, and gain a leader. Nice, nice. Bognadova. From the name, I think this seems to be a woman, a female. Because I heard in Russian names, the ones ending with A is often a female honorific or something. Alpine training. Oh, okay, cool. So you can actually traverse through this, you know, German hinterland or the Black Forest. Is it Black Forest? Without any kind of penalty to each movement. So yeah, it's going to be a recon unit or something. Not really. Too small a range for it to do anything in terms of recon, but yeah, very encouraging. Alright, so this guy will... Yeah, I have to make a... Yeah, I think so. guys will still... He's in the range. Yeah, still in the range, so that's good. Next turn, I think I can use two of my tanks to destroy this artillery. And yeah, and then basically I will be home free, hopefully. This guy will just have to come back to where it was. And this guy will... Wait a second. Two left, and I have a... Oh, I can destroy this guy. Good. Yeah. Let's make sure that I destroy everything. If I... Can I overrun it and then destroy it? Yeah, I can. No, I can overrun it. That's not good. Oh well. Okay. It has one more shot left. Alright. Yeah, this guy can actually do some bad stuff. Can you attack? No. It's just outside of the range. So, IS-2. Okay, IS-2. Maybe I can use this guy. Yep. Yeah, it's not going to be good. Alright, let's try to protect the tank. And is there any stricken unit that I can target? Not really. Let's leave this guy for later. Let's just check what is happening here up on the road. No. Wow, thank God it didn't reveal anything. Oh my goodness, twice in a row. I should be familiar with these controls by now. Yeah, there's another fortress. Well met, fortress. Aggressive attack guy. No time for dawdle. Try to just force the issue here. IS-2, okay. Has one more shot left. I wanna make it actually worthwhile. Alright, artillery is nowhere to be seen, so I capture this. And this lonely guy is going to follow up. Yeah, bridging. Yeah, you come here as well. And you... I think you should just, well... Stay here. Guards. Yeah, follow up. I have no organic transport. That sucks. Okay. Are you in the range? Yes, you are. Ah, goodness. Right. Let's just get over with. Nice. Okay. A bit stable now, finally. Now, maybe this guy can... No, this definitely can follow up. In a pretty good place between this tank. Yeah, just for one turn. Can I make it so that I can still cover for this tank? Well, this guy can make the farthest amount of progress. I guess here. Yeah, I guess so. And here, let's see. Oh my goodness. Still organic transport, but they don't really have that kind of mobility to fight the guy on the hill. Yeah, but this is the most natural place where you can set yourself up. Alright. Now, can this guy move? No, this guy should just stay where it is. And this guy, this is out of ammo, so he has to recharge. Maybe just stay here. Alright, this guy will also go back. Because of that air presence that I don't really know when, where it's going to go. So if it goes south, if these guys go south, then I have chance to attack the all units on the north just because that is going to take them that much. I guess on an extra turn to get and target the air force, our piecemeal air force now. I have 502. Wow, okay, so I can definitely fix that guy up a bit. To fix this tank as good as new. Wow, the tales that tank could tell after the war is over. The bridging guy. Wow, okay, he's going to travel all the way to capture another point, but I'm kind of afraid. Nah, not afraid of the flank here. Let's just capture it. I don't really see any... Yeah, I don't see any artillery about there in particular. This guy will just stay one more turn to cover the guards. And that's it, 8 turns left. Oh man, not moving away that much. Ah, okay, fine, suppress one. They're attacking IS-3s, like, on equal terms. The infantry is rushing out. Wow, drawing 5. Of course you lost out. 7 turns left, okay. Alright. I can damage this guy. Let's see. Drawing 2. Alright. This guy is all fixed up. Probably, yeah, all recharged. It's in the forest, so yeah, it's going to be pretty difficult, but I need to get this guy off our backs. Wow. Stronger tank needed. There's IS-3, of course. Which should I target? SF? Oh, SF should resume traveling up this road. KV-85 should do it. Nah, maybe I should just... yeah, use this guy. Destroy, destroy, nice, okay. And 27, yep, yep, that's good. Alpine training. Engineer, breaching, can breaching fight? My goodness, yeah, they can definitely show the difference in experience. Alright, recharge. It's a bit of a struggle. Overrun, yeah, alright, good. And keep attacking the artillery. Nice. Alright, the road is more or less open. Let's see what this guy can do. One is... okay, alright, so I just fire up on the hill. Took out artillery, basically. Self-propelled artillery. With the... I think self-propelled artillery leaders only has marksman, which is increases its range by 1, just like all the other normal variety artilleries. 27, yeah, I have to do it. Wow, okay, really lucky there. Very lucky. And, oh, okay, entrenchment is 0. Wow, and 6. Now this guy can make a good headway. With the breaching guy. Let's see if the breaching guy can damage this guy a bit. Ah, man. Oh, organic transport. They made use of. That's why I didn't provide them with trans in the first place. I don't think it would have made a difference, but yeah. Okay, since... yeah, I need to make brisk progress here. Okay, let's just attack with full abandon then. Alright. Put this guy right over here. And... the strip pen with entrenchment. Okay. 6 and 4, not going to happen. Yeah, this guy we need to... oh, did reveal someone. Oh my goodness, there's extra soldiers. Okay. Alright, so let's check what is up here. Nothing much. I do not want to overextend my forces too much. But I need to make a... definitely start traveling because I don't have a lot of turns left. So... yeah, these guys really all have to travel. This guy also, maybe can make another bridge or something along the way. This is Forstenwald. Another target, next target. Man, this is really, I mean, the room I'm in right now is really warm. The string of just sweltering weather, folks. Racking your brain does, just like computer system or any other machinery, does tend to get you a bit warmer, it seems. I don't know, just seems like it. Kind of suffocating, to be honest with you. So I might like make some mistakes out of just sheer, just trying to get the sweat off my eyes or something. Anyways, yeah, enough of that. Am I complaining about the weather all the time? Yeah, okay, let's check with the... No, you stay there. Let the recon do the work. Okay, so no artillery is in the immediate vicinity. So let's get cracking. Who should I target? Well, this guy should come back, I think. Maybe check up north. What's happening up in the north? So let's get this guy first. No, this guy first. Yeah. Oh, okay, artillery. That's good. That's actually, yeah, that's actually pretty decent because I was able to find that artillery before it gets too late, exposing my... 0-7, yeah. Exposing my infantry. You run, I will follow. Can I follow? 22. No, not yet. Not yet. This, okay. Nice. All right. Making some progress. And how about the stricken tank? What is happening up here? Yeah, replace it. Resurrected. So those only good things about the fate of our army that I was able to bring back the dead tank to life in one turn, no less. All right, so you have artillery, I have artillery. This guy can chill pretty fast, definitely can burn rubber. I'm very happy with that. And I haven't seen anybody here, so let's cross the stream. Try to follow as best as possible the main army, and this guy can stay. Yeah, I like where it is. Let me just check once more. Okay. Yeah, I think so. I can. Oh, okay. Can target this baddie. That's nice. Whittling down their strength in the air. Nothing bad about that. Okay. Yeah, just stay close. Don't burn unnecessary fuel. And these guys will have to bear. Green and bear. The next excursion against the Stoßtruppen. Maybe it's going to be suppressed. And this guy as well. I hope there's no artillery down there though. Yeah, maybe I can sneak my bombers down there. Yeah, and then attack. Oh wow, alright, they haven't crossed the, they haven't crossed the river themselves yet, but who knows what's going to happen. And he revealed my bomber by mistake. Oh, that sucks. Jesus, okay. Things are not really, well, I mean the Air Force is kind of irrelevant. More or less. Not you. But the tank, can it move? No, I guess it just stay where it is. Yeah, just stay where it is. And this guy will also... wow. Alright. Should I destroy this guy? Yeah. Oh, okay. Better than I expected. Okay. So I guess that pays for being a bit aggressive once in a while. Okay, this guy. Alright, so 7 turns, and let's see. Yep, yeah, suppressed. Oh, here we go. Oh, okay. Didn't target my bomber, surprising. Now I get hit. Hey, that was a pretty bad decision on their part. Yeah, forest definitely makes a difference against this elite stripping. Ah, boy. Yeah, they're still entrenched, folks. Hard to deal with. Definitely hard to deal with. Get replaced. You are too important a unit. And let's just give the fight to them. Yeah. Let's give the fight to them. Does it make sense? Everywhere. Right. So it's overrun fodder. Nice. Okay, good. Very good. And this guy can actually move now. What? Oh. Just use organic engineer and we can attack. Oh my god, it's not going to end up well. Okay, just move to the road. We can use organic transport in the next turn. And how about you? You spend all the... Wow, it's basically full experience now. Very interesting. And this guy should move a bit backward. Okay, I can finish this guy off. No, maybe he should just move away from it all. Just stay here, I guess. Oh my god, artillery. Yep. Kind of lucky just discovering artillery here. Wow. Yeah, it's not really worth the effort then. This guy, what can this guy do? I mean, this only 3 strength, so I think I can be safe leaving this guy. Yeah, I think so. Alright. Get out of the way. Being a leader. Another day for T-34. And let's see if I can... Is there... Yeah, I can use this. Just to try to take a peek at what is going on. Oh, just a lone fortress. That is a good news, but I need to make sure that this guy is seeing what is he seeing, because seeing is... well, this guy can actually spot for us a bit. Oh, there might be artillery, so it doesn't get any easier. Okay, so... yep, there might be... This is SF? Nope, this is SF, okay. Just ignoring the entrenchment is a boon for us. Artillery? Nope, no artillery. That's good. Can probably just destroy that, right? Oh my god. Oh my goodness. Alright, so what is the situation now? Okay, so after I get this, there's a... Well, the progression is going to be just... Yeah, it has to stay in the south. There's a bunch of bridges here that can probably cross and make use of the breaching guys, so I think I did make a bad decision there. I just need to use my breaching guys to follow up on the little tributaries and streams there and try to cross it. Alright, so can this guy overrun this guy? Yeah, barely. And treble? Nope. There's definitely a lot of defenders. Yep. A lot of defenders. And still going to, yeah, still going to help these guys. Air defense, I mean. Yeah, try to protect the artillery. And yeah, these guys have all moved. Alright. And now, yeah, resume your journey to the heart of German capital. Now, what say you? Now let's see how things are different. Okay. Wow, that sucks. This guy, yeah, already has a leader. Can overrun. Nice. And can you? Oh no, that's, damn it. Wow, okay. Holy crap, I didn't know that there was a unit there, but of course, there was a stricken guy that basically ran away from the battlefield. And only 2 strengths, so even though I was ambushed, I was able to destroy it. Very lucky. Very lucky indeed. Nice, wow, yeah, this is something that I definitely envisioned. The IS-2s or 3s of being able to do. Let's check out whether they're here. Yeah, I could have been surprised once again. But no artillery, so I can attack these regular guys, I think. Yeah, 27. The lightning strikes twice. Oh, okay. So, but I was able to push them away. That's good. And the breaching guys can capture it. Or this guy can capture it. No, this is in the city, so I not do that. Capture it. Yeah, and then get out, and maybe if this guy comes back, then I can make sure it's destroyed with this artillery in the next turn. So, alright. Follow up with the air defense and of course the artillery, which is going to be very important in the final few turns. Oh, Kiberian is just outside. Going to be expecting a big surprise there in the form of a very big German tank, if the commenter's last video is correct. I don't have any reason to doubt any of their very helpful advice on the state of things in the German capital. Maybe that big tank is going to be manned by none other than you know who. Still expecting Eckenhell to pop up in some manner or form, but haven't really seen him in the Soviet campaign, although he did make a lot of appearance in the Western campaign. Maybe he wanted to be captured by the allies instead of the, you know, big red army, big bad red army trying to exact revenge on the west of Oder right now. No, you just stay there, you protect that artillery. All right, so this guy should just stay here. It's a gamble, but just stay. All right, so 6 turns left. Wow, yeah, turn definitely flies. Still have that, yeah, persistence about it. Oh my god! Oh my god! Just as I said it, he makes its appearance. Just as I said it. Wow. The mouse. BD. Big death, I guess. Unfortunately, it's only, half strength, so I can probably make a pretty good example of it. Oh, I cannot with this understrength tank, although it is a leader. And this is out of ammo. Oh my goodness, it's out of ammo. Wow. So somebody has to take care of this, and then this tank is other than the aggressive tech guy. All right. Nice! Wow, that was very scary, folks, but yeah, I was surprised for some reason. It was heavy, I mean, you couldn't really travel that far. And yeah, I should have checked its status before killing it outright, but I was really excited about it. Yeah, it was like traveling along this road all that time and wasn't able to see or hear the din of battle very close by in the forest. Maybe it was raining or something. Oh, it was only overcast, but that's very impressive. And you get out. And you attack. Oh, I should have attacked this guy with the artillery first, damn it! That sucks. Yep. I have places to go, so. Alright, what is this? An artillery, huh? Okay. 73. Turning back. Yeah, okay. And you. Nice! And out of ammo. My. Reaching. Engineer, you go a bit farther. Nice. You capture it. Let's see, doubly better. See, watch up. Nothing much. It's good. Oh my god, what is this? Elephant. Well, I hope it comes. It has a pretty good amount of experience, but just like the mouse, it's going to be pretty easy to. Okay, so it's a lot of forest, so alpine training might help of new leader. But yeah, just like the mouse, I think I'll be able to do away with this tank or anti-tank pretty quickly, especially it does lose half of its effectiveness as it moves. Was it half? Yeah, I think it was around half. Yeah, but here I'm going to make the strongest showing. Yeah, okay. So just follow up. Yep, there's nothing. Okay. Oh my. Alright, just scared them away a bit. The rest of these guys should all move. I'm going to bring this engineer. Let's check how the forces are shaping up. Definitely committing more tanks here into the main road to Berlin, but I need to also make sure that I bolster my forces in the south, southern prong. So, yeah. This guy, yeah, just have to follow the road. You capture this first. And this guy will head south. Yeah, that's how it should work. Nope, not you. You just join the main line of attack right here. Yeah, two IS3s. Nice. Knew that they're going to be together in the end. A happy ending for them. T-34-85. I really want to finish these guys off. Then if I bring more tanks, any more tanks than there is right now. Oh, I should bring more tanks, yeah. Okay, it's out of shells and out of everything, but has a pretty interesting tendency to tie up this ME-262 for some reason. So I just keep some of the tanks here at least, and then this guy can slip through undetected. As long as I don't reveal anything down there, I think it'll be home free, like slinking along the southern edge of the map. Alright, so this guy should definitely move. Right here, yeah. And here. Nice. Let's get a move on here, yep. Yeah. All the guards. Any planes? Nope. No planes around, nice. Can I destroy this guy? Well, I can. That was a try. I guess I tried. Yeah, stay there. Need to clear up the road a bit. This guy should definitely stay. I don't want to move this guy yet. Yeah, may as well just replace this guy in one fell swoop. Alright. Stay, stay. Everybody stay. And 5 turns. Okay, so 4 turns is going to be very important. These guys are going away, seems? No, okay. Wow, right in the crosshairs. I don't really care, I mean... Oh, they're going back, of course. And they might be purchasing more units, so if that comes to pass, it's going to be pretty bad for us. So I need to get a move on here. Without question, and yeah, replace these guys. I don't wanna throw them away needlessly, and this guy should... See what is up in the Berlin area. And maybe travel a bit farther. Yeah, like here. Alright, Dean of Activity. Okay. 88, definitely move from the last airfield to here. This guy probably needs to refuel. Needs to be replaced. IS-2 is going to... Well, IS-3 is going to maybe... Clear this guy. Nice. Yep, that's what IS-3s are for. Who cares if entrenchment or forest, they're going to just run over everything in each path. I believe that elephant is going to come up here soon. And maybe it's going to get surprised once again. Hopefully. Alright. Move away with the artillery bearing down upon Berlin. Nice. Yep. It's a pretty good setup. Pretty good setup. This breaching guy. No guards. Where's the breaching guy? Did I already move the breaching guy here? Yeah, breaching is already there, yes. More pathways toward Berlin, yes. I don't think they're really needed though. But I can put the breaching guy here, for example, and then move with more force. Move with definite... I guess pressure them a bit more from every side. That's what I was trying to say. Oh boy, it is really, really warm here. Maybe I should open the door, but the noise, no noise coming from outside. 1 and 5, nice. 3 and 6, are suitably entrenched? Oh, okay, nice. Walk into there and then destroy this guy, nice. Alright, so southern pathway is stable, more or less. Ah, not stable at all, okay. Can you shoot? No, you cannot shoot, but I know where you are, and I think this guy will be provoked. This guy, I think, moved like one hex or something. Let's check before it's too late and I destroy it outright. 200 even? Pretty impressive. Although it has no leader, so it's going to get its strength cut pretty substantially after it moves to position itself to shoot at one of the targets. 18 and 10, it can only move 3. So yeah, that's why it was only able to move one hex. Panzer General 2 is harsh enough game that it doesn't round up any cut movement points. If it's odd number that has been cut into 2, then yeah, I don't think it rounds up, only runs down. Anyways. Oh, Alpine training guy. Where is this Alpine training guy? Nikolaev. It might be very useful though. Yeah, this guy is Alpine training. Right? Yeah, so let's see if it works. Let's see if this gal can walk across the forest as if it's nothing. It has plenty of fuel still, yeah, so maybe. Going to be pretty cool to watch because there's a lot of logjam here. So breaching guy is going to help us maybe cross in the next turn for the infantry. Right into the forest, so it's not going to help. But for armor, maybe it's going to make the difference. I have a lot of tanks coming along still on both sides, so no problems there. And these guys are, you know, keeping the flank. Yeah, so finally the enemy 262 lost interest. Yeah, okay, still can suppress them somewhat here. 4 and 7, and it's clear, so let me just check. Yeah. Next turn, maybe. I'm going to overrun this guy and then try to see what's up here. Straggling guys trying to threaten us from the flank. I hope it doesn't cross the stream. I think that artillery, whatever artillery was stationed over here on the ridge, I think has moved somewhere to protect the last bit of point. Speaking of which, let's check. So all the objectives have been taken. We do have a large column of armor bearing down upon Berlin. I'm going to make sure that I move this guy closer and closer and closer to Berlin and see. Let's just try to place them in a so that we can attack it the last few turns and target all the newly purchased units that the Germans might bring, definitely. Okay, so this guy, resilient tank, done enough to basically retire, but I mean, if it insists on coming along, then I have no complaint. Okay, yeah, pretty good setup here. Yeah, nice, it all works out. This guy should just stay. Oh, and where is this place? ISU, oh, okay, so it has been... This guy's pretty slow. Bard coming down the height. Stay here. Yeah, you stay, and you also stay. Yeah, okay, good, protecting the point. 3 turns left. Wow. Oh, just attacking straight up. Okay, tying down the aircraft. I seen some tanks moving around. Okay, so elephant is definitely moving. There's 2 elephants or something, or is it the one that moved? Oh, just got out of the forest. Okay. Alright, so what can this guy do? Alright, so breaching. Oh, wow, okay. I don't know whether it's going to be useful, but yeah, it's not really useful at all. So this guy should just travel as fast as possible, just see what is up. Alright, nothing. Okay, go down and just follow up. Just outside the range of each 2-range gun. Yeah. Oh man, my northern group has to really pull its weight. And look at this, yeah, look at that Alpine training. Learned from Finland, no doubt. And just go straight through, nice! I wanted to try out a new trait before everything's said and done. Yeah, Alpine training is pretty impressive. Oh my god, alright, let's go into it right away. Who is this? Colon. Oh, it's air defense. I thought it was some kind of some weird prototypical weapons that they had brought to bear. Alright, let's just get this guy's revved up. I think, well, there's a lot of anti-tank. Not anti-tank, anti-air for some reason. Well, you're expecting Americans, you're going to get some tank loving from the Soviets. They were probably ready to accept the Western allies with open arms or something. But they were prepared just in case that the Americans brought bombers, but should have purchased more tanks. Alright, anyways. Yep, so it's 21. Oh, pretty impressive. It's IS-2. Masaryk, yes, it's Masaryk, no doubt. Volkstrom, so these guys are not that strong. Alright. This is rather worrying, but I guess I can just target it. 1 and 4, 1 and 6, who should I target first? Let's open up the way. How far can you? Okay, so let's get this guy then. Nice, overrun. And okay. Yeah, it's going to be a pain in the ass. 0 and 3, okay. Yeah, this guy will have to move. This guy will have to move. That's right. And then the guards, bridging, okay. So bridging is going to, I don't know whether there's going to be, oh, there is artillery here, but I don't know about here. I want to check, but it's a bit too far for me to check. I can probably move this unit here. How far can you travel? I don't really see anything here in the 4 hex way, so even if it gets attacked, I think I can provide a bit of a buffer zone, at least, here. And then boom, all my artillery's here. Okay, good. I can move my artillery's here now. And another artillery, I hope I can move it. This guy cannot actually directly attack the unit, but I just are on the safe side. No, just stay here. Should I actually... This is another problem. I should be a bit more aggressive with the artillery and then just see. Yeah, and then if it works, then I'll be able to capture the northern point in the next turn, I think. If it doesn't work, then, well, I mean, it's too bad. I should be aggressive here and then use the recon to provide a buffer zone here. Buffer zone. Alright, attack and displace. Yeah, useless, but I expected that. 12 inch, yeah. Reaching. Some of the artillery is going to come under attack. Yeah. Not enough hex to provide air defense for everyone. This guy will just stay. Not going to be a factor in the end. This Tostrupin is kind of threatening. Alright. Yeah. Move here, and the breaching guy is able to put a breach down there. Maybe it's a bit too late for it to do it. Yeah, I could have just gone provide a path directly into the southern point, but man, could have been very useful. 26. Are they moving? I think they're moving. They might be moving. Yep, they're moving. Alright, so you just stay in position. Stay in your positions, yes. Maybe I should bring this guy down. Yeah, he's not going to be a factor in the end, so I'm going to bring this guy down. Bolter the forces in the south. Keep each place, yep, stay there. And you stay there as well, and oh my goodness. Yeah, it's protecting the point over the space. I think the enemy's 262 is going to follow suit. It's going to just stay over here and hover. Yeah. So take this point and then just attack directly. But you might purchase a unit. So it's in the range. Yeah, it's in the range, so I just stay there and not move. Alright, so 2 turns left. My. Oh, it did move. Wow, it moved away. Oh, wow. Alright. It's in the forest, but... It's in the forest. But it didn't really matter. Yeah, the Germans are now Russian. Okay, so that was pretty good that I, you know, put some tanks there to protect the flank. Okay, the breaching guy, can you move? Ah, my god, he was in the front of the group. Now what happened to him? Okay. okay. No matter. I think I can destroy these guys anyways. Pastries. The aggressive attack guy will make a lot of dent here. Nice. 1 in 6. Yeah, get out of the way. And yeah, the artillery is going to just clear this space. 5 and 4. Can I overrun? Is that enough? Okay, has 2 shots left. Alright, okay. And I need my recon to see. I think this guy in the south is able to do that work. What happened here? Okay, so this guy will need to... Wow, there's no target. Alright. So that is also under strength for some reason. And I need to go into the forest and see. Yeah, they have extra units and stuff like that. IS-3 is able to... My goodness, yep. Just take this point. And then just run roughshod. Okay, let's do that then. How about this guy? He has 1 more shot though, so I want to damage this guy, Belberind. Just clear the zone. It's in the city now, but you know, they fought in the city with tanks and stuff like that, so I mean, you know, this is just exactly what is going on now with IS-3s, and I think IS-2s were almost, I don't know whether it was effective, but definitely joining the urban warfare, trying to extract the German defenders. Basically building by building and cellar to cellar. So get this guy out. And it's out of ammo, goodness. Yeah, the one thing bad about the... That is unfortunate about the... The cavalry is coming though. The one thing unfortunate about the... What is it? The IS-3 is, of course, with the IS-2 is the amount of ammo. Amount of ammo that is definitely lacking. Of course, when you know, things get a bit tense and desperate, then these kind of things do happen. And yeah, it can definitely make a difference between glorious, brilliant victory and just not as impressive victory, or even, you know, God forbid, strategic victory. But if I'm lucky, I'll be able to just pull through. I hope that is going to be the case. We're getting a lot more prestige, I think. I'm just trying to fix my units as I go though, so... And this guy, yeah. This guy is unfortunate. Any other unit I can target? Well, at least I have a lot of tanks in the forest, so... This guy has no ammo, no ammo. No, oh, a lot of ammo. Okay, so aggressive attack guy might be able to do something. And this guy also maybe to come down and then shoot across to lower the entrenchment. And what is this guy? Engineer? The engineer guy might be able to cross into the last point. How many turns I have? 2 turns left? Okay, so last turn is coming up next. Yeah, definitely. And... Ah, this breaching guy. Damn it, I misused him so bad. Yeah. Oh my goodness, is it raining? It's snowing! It's snowing in April 22nd in Berlin. My goodness, I have seen everything now. Oh my goodness, but it's going to matter in the end. If it stops snowing, then I can make sure that these guys are all covered. Because, you know, these guys might come in and then try to block us in our last effort to try to get these guys out. But it's snowing in Berlin in April, folks. I mean, this is just crazy. Yeah, I don't know what the real weather was like back in 1945. raining cats and dogs or it's snowing in the parade of Soviet Union, maybe it just reminds them of home or something. Alright, so I need to bring this guy down a bit here. And just, yeah, be able to attack both of these points. And okay, so these guys are moving now. Oh my god! Yeah, get back where you came from, across the river. And the more artillery is coming in, nice. Yep. Reinforcements coming. This guy and this guy is okay. I think this guy is okay where it is, yep. Protecting both artilleries now, and this guy just stay there to protect the bridgehead. This guy might just go across, but I'm not so sure. Maybe he's still there though. Alright, folks. Yeah, wow. They're buying units. Oh my god, artillery unit. Yeah, they purchased some units there. The infantry, to be more exact. Alright, so my aggressive play didn't work out there. But now I'm able to. Okay, so this is bridging, still stripping. Ah, I don't think I'll be able to make it. Alright, let this. Oh my god, this guy is just blocked. Oh, they're buying units. A lot. Alright, so let's make this count, folks. Let's make this count. Can you get out of the place? This guy should get out. This guy should get out. This guy should. Oh my god. Okay, they purchased so many units. Alright. And this guy also need to get this guy down a peg. Bolstrom. Berlin Defense Force, I think that's what it means. Alright, this guy should get out of the way. It's like playing Tetris. Oh, can I shoot? Can I shoot? What about you? Can you do anything? Let's surround these guys. And 4 and 5. Do it! 4 and 4. Nice! Nice, nice, nice. My god, okay. Goodness, I don't think I can make it, folks. Nope, 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 nope. Just stay there. Ah, jeez. Okay. Anyways. Ah, can I shoot across forest? I should have known. How can I be so absent-minded there? Nope, don't do that. I want to get this bomber out. What's the weather? Overcast? My goodness. Alright, I can still make it, I think. I need to just attack this guy. And capture it. And use this guy. Maybe rugged defense effect. Can I shoot, huh? Alright, well, I mean, I can overrun, but. That is tense. Ah, man, I should have known that I cannot shoot across forest. Aggressive tech guy. Oh yes, I can make it. Nice. I'm not going to even target this guy because I'm afraid he's going to spend my mobility, although he wouldn't. But I'm going to win this game. Wow, this is great in a brilliant fashion. But in the end, I also made it really, really wrong and really hard for me once again. Yeah, so I'm going to just win the game, and this is going to be the battle of the start of Battle of Berlin. I did it pretty, I'm really lucky that I was able to do it, and I'm not going to just press anything. The only thing I'm going to do is just enter into this Berlin proper and end the mission. Hopefully it's going to say Berlin victory, Allied victory. Yeah, so this has been very tense in the end because I didn't use the breaching guy right here. Oh, where is this guy? Yeah, right here. I mean, I could have just used this breaching guy and set up a breach here to save at least like few, I think 3 or 4 hacks even for these tanks to get to the intended target. But in the end, the leaders basically won out, and despite my worries about not being able to have enough ammo, definitely happened, but this KV-85 with its 9 ammo capacity, I think it did rearm itself, I think once along the way, was able to pull through. So yeah, great. Brilliant victory in the last turn, the last, I guess, movement allowed for my tank. It's great, it feels pretty good to end in a brilliant fashion.
The party has brought the great patriotic war to a victorious end, and we celebrate your role in this final battle. The banners of the SSSR fly over the Reichstag, and our liberation mission is complete. All the peoples of the world herald your name for freeing them from the fascist nightmare. Comrade General, a dacha on the Black Sea has been granted you and awaits your pleasure. And now, vodka!
This guy's definitely feeling it, folks. Yeah. Definitely has a character to match that stereotypical growl of the Russian, hardened and rugged Russian soldier or military type. Listens to the Volga song as he fills his samovar with vodka or something. I mean, he's definitely happy, and yeah, I'm sure very glad that I was able to finish with all the brilliant victories. I don't know what SSSR mean. USSR means, I guess, United Socialist Soviet Republics, but I don't know what SSSR means. Maybe it's just Super Soviet Socialist Republics or something. But the red banner definitely was flown over the Reichstag. That was another whole operation unto itself. And I guess Zhukov's battalion got the honors of doing that. To the chagrin of Konev, who was ordered to stay away, heck away from the Reichstag and then the central Berlin area. Yeah, so General Masaryk, although his last name is, you know, Czechoslovakian, of course, I mean, in USSR, in communism, there's, I guess, absence of national boundaries. It's all like brotherhood under one particular committee or something. So yeah, Masaryk's last name is rather well known in Czechoslovakia. I think it's actually the name of a first president of the republic. I don't know whether it was Republic, but yeah, if each president is definitely Republic. And also his son was Jan Masaryk, who was a foreign minister for Czechoslovakia now after the war being installed with, you know, socialist or communist government friendly to Soviet Union. But unfortunately, I think he was trying to play the both sides of the aisle. I don't know, like, he tried to get a bit of a Western support and he was deemed pro-Western. And very unfortunately, he was accosted by the Russian agent or something and defenestrated, killed, basically assassinated. So yeah, I mean, you know, that story behind the last name, and then I searched a bit if this last name has any famous people related to it and associated with it, and it definitely does. Well, now I'm going to, well, General Masaryk is going to retire to Adasha on the Black Sea. It's, I think, where the Olympic was held, right? Like Sochi and other places like that in the Black Sea, where the weather is really nice and balmy with the gentle waves. Caviar is everywhere. Yeah, very nice to have Dasha. So fascist nightmare is over, and the red banner is flying everywhere. And now we see the victory cinema or victory movie. Wow. Masaryk gets full 300. Oh, okay. So 300, I guess, is the maximum amount of score that you can achieve, because I was able to achieve, you know, all 6 victories on the, like, Soviet campaign side. That kind of means that the German campaign is the hardest to achieve 300. I guess it does signify at this list or the leaderboard is actually kind of skewed toward the Western Allies missions, because of course, you know, in the early going, especially in the Defender Reich, it is rather hard for the Germans to achieve a brilliant victory, and General Eckenhell had to basically sweep across the, you know, entire Europe in brilliant fashion in order to match the score here. As you can see, he's being pushed further and further down. I think he's in the 6th or 7th place now. Yeah, let's see the dossier and see how he did. Of course, all 6 you know, medals, gold medals, or victorious, brilliant victory medals. I guess 50 each, coming up to 300. And yeah, last mission as well, I think I lost 1 artillery unit. That's pretty surprising. I was almost close to having resilient tank scuttled, but was able to survive. I don't know if I had some huge amount of fortune or luck. And yeah, did pretty well for Soviet Union. It's pretty good. And that basically brings us to the last of this episode and this series of Panzer General 2. Yeah. This game has been very, very good. Very good. I really enjoyed playing this game, and I really didn't play a game of this ilk for, I guess, the closest turn-based game that I played that bears a, even a passing semblance to this game was Civilization 2, 4, you know, the strategic game that had a turn-based gameplay, and that was it. I didn't really play anything that was more in-depth, and you cannot really say that Panzer General 2 is a, you know, in-depth game. There's definitely more games out there that really delves deeply into the warfare. The art of warfare, especially using tanks such as, you know, released from the same developer, SSI, Steel Panthers. And there's also the combat mission games that uses 3D graphics, that uses not really a turn-based thing, I hear, but more phased kind of a turn where you set up everything and then see everything unfold at the same time. So I guess that's pretty interesting, and also in certain respect better in terms of watching that very tense element situations play out. But Panzer General 2, on the whole, I think I really like the game. I think the sides are well balanced, gameplay is very well structured, has a pretty good pacing. Every mission actually doesn't go over like 3 hours or something like that, although it has that addictive one more turn kind of feel to it, or quality to it. And yeah, so this is really a game I recommend, and I guess I have to show you the credits here, or the, you know, to bring the series to a close as I want to. And yeah, this has been Panzer General 2. As the credits roll, I guess I need to mention a few things. I'd like to say, well, let's just go over like what particular campaign I enjoy the most in this series. Let's just go over that. I enjoyed, I think, the first campaign the best, the Eckenhell one, because it definitely was the longest. It had a dynamic branching out of the campaign. There are certain scenarios that I didn't get to play just because of the way I played. There's definitely certain maps that I could have dealt with if my performance on the field was not good enough. Well, if I played even better than I did, then I could have gone and skipped even more maps. If I achieved a brilliant victory at in Northern France, just name escapes me. But if I did really well there, then I could have just skipped and go straight to Windsor. Then of course go to United States. That's a pretty short credit. But yeah, in the end, I enjoyed the German campaign the most, then comes the Soviet Union, then I guess the Western Allies one. The Soviet Union I enjoyed because of basically the tanks. I like the tanks, and it does feel, you know, better to control like T-34s and developing it than, you know, using Fireflies all the time. And of course on the American side, the bombers kind of skew that way, but a Russian army, I think, allows you to sort of specialize in either, I guess, anti-tank or tank. They have a pretty good amount of anti-tank too, so that's pretty cool. Yeah, that's it. So I enjoy the German campaign the most, and then the side that I like the most, I mean, that's kind of different because the campaign itself is a bit different from the side as a whole that is represented. The side that I enjoy the most, of course, I have to mention or like the best, is again the Germans, because they have the most units and they have like naval ships and stuff like that that I got to use in Malta. So yeah, once again, I like the German units the best, and let's go and then delve into the units. For example, the tanks. The best tank I believe is Panther G, and I do like the Panther G's the most. Followed closely by the Fireflies. Yeah, Firefly has been very interesting unit, has like 21 attack rating but very little defense, but definitely was instrumental, especially with leaders with shock tactics, that was able to make a very good showing. The Panther G's I enjoy the most using because of its power, its mobility, it has the capacity for shells, yeah, everything. Best artillery, I guess I have to say that it's once again the German one, the KA-18 is very good, has a 5 range and just destructive as a whole. And I think it does take into account that I didn't get to use a lot of artillery leaders in the rest of the other campaigns, so I had a leader for my artillery with KA-18, so with 6 range it was just an awesome to behold. Go 20 tank, I think in terms of anti-tank, I like the American one. Let me just check. Let's check the American one. Let's see what Dessau. I think Dessau is going to provide us with the full breadth of the anti-tank here. Yep, so I like this unit the best, I think. Yeah, I get to use that guy a lot. As you can see, I had a leader here. So it's pretty cool that I was able to bring this guy or string it along until I was able to achieve a full experience almost. Yeah, M36, yeah, I liked it the most. It does have a pretty good amount of mobility and power at the same time. Yeah, that's it. And okay, let's see. Let's just go into here and then go down. Anti-air, oh, anti-air, yeah. Bellwervent is the best anti-air in my opinion, at least in this game, on the German side. Yeah, it has a decent amount of coverage with 2 range and also pretty good amount of offense, and it can also it's also considered hard target, and it's actually a pretty good platform onto which the Germans installed their anti-air weapons, and it was pretty good. And I also had a leader, I think, in the Oak Ridge mission, so I was able to just move everywhere and shoot at the American bombers with no restrictions, so it was pretty cool. Infantry, well, you have a ranger here, but in the end I like the engineers. I mean, regardless of their nationalities, I like the engineers the most because of their sheer power of ignoring entrenchment. Engineers, yeah, and then it does definitely bear out in the prestige cost, and then it has a very nice and overall rounded ratings across the board as far as infantry is concerned. And as far as nationalities, I think the Finnish engineers had the best amount of defensive rating, and then German ones had the I'm not so sure, I have to check, but then the overall engineers are the best. I guess in the German terms it's called pioneers. Alright, so going down to recon, maybe I should get out and then show you the next unit that I like the best as far as the recon is concerned. Yeah, these are the British units, and the recon I like the best, AEC-3s. I used them extensively in the British campaign, especially Khan, where he was able to shine through. And I think I have a leader here, no? Oh no, I don't have a leader, but yeah, I mean, this guy has been very useful in all British missions. Has a pretty decent amount of, I guess, anti-armor, hard target or soft target attacks, and decent amount of defense, and has all the qualities of having a pretty good fuel and the mobility, and of course the spotting range is sublime. And yeah, it was able to do really well. And then probably the only time, except for the German ones, all German missions here and there, that I was compelled enough to overstrengthen this guy in past its full strength. Alright, so let's go into the fighters. Yes, the fighters, of course, there are a lot of German ones. And you probably guessed that I like the ME-262 the most. And of course, I got the leader for it, and there's no doubt about its power and its effectiveness. huge amount of readings across the board in both defensive and offensive role. Only thing that may be a bit of a drawback is its ammo capacity, but it has a pretty cool sound. I mean, you know, it has everything. It's the first jet that is in any kind of a mainstream or mass manufactured use or presence. So ME262 is definitely the best. And then the bombers, of course, we have to go back to the American side. Ah, yes, the American bombers. They are the best. They're the best, without question. I think there are a lot of them still around on air shows. And if you have a chance to see these guys in splendor, on its glory and splendor, definitely go and see those shows. Yes, let's just check here. Yeah. You have A20s and A26Bs. I like 26Bs. I mean, just based on the pure strength alone, I should say that this is my favorite tactical bomber. But depending on the usage and the history of the units that I used during the American campaign, I have to go with A20s. I think they definitely pulled more weight in terms of taking the different units and destroying them in the end. I don't know why, but A20s were definitely... Some of them were upgraded, of course, to A26Bs, but these guys definitely proved its mettle. And these are the first American bomber units that I really used to its full potential. And from the get-go, I think, from Salerno. And A20s definitely made an impression, more impression than any other bombers that were more of an incremental upgrade over this model. So A20 is, to me, the best bomber that I like the most. And that brings us to... Oh, okay, so I mentioned everything. So yeah, I mean, the Germans had a lot of good weapons, definitely. Yeah, so anything else to mention? Well, I guess that's it, I think. I'd just like to mention that I really thank you guys for, you know, subscribing and or viewing the videos and the series. I'm glad that you guys found a bit of enjoyment from this series. It's been one of the longest things I have ever undertaken, honestly. Taking me along, I think around a year, I think so. Considering the episode numbers, I think 43, discounting the fact that I did a couple of silly Christmas episodes or something like that. I mean, I still need to edit this and put it up, and I really need to do it fast enough to even, you know, come close to the current rate that I have got going, which is, you know, far from the episode per week. What am I speaking about? But anyways, yeah, thank you so much for giving me good advice, especially Piano 688, KRC Circ, and MAM162, giving me a lot of encouragement along the way with a lot of advice. So without you guys, this LP series would have been not as enjoyable. As far as the next LP, I don't know when it's going to be, but I have to probably just look over certain possibilities and see what games I like most. And this LP was rather special in that this was based on, you know, historical times, so I had to like research and just to, you know, spruce it up and to make things a bit more interesting rather than, you know, staring the turn-based screen the entirety of the time. I tried to provide some commentary, some silly commentary, bad jokes along the way to lighting things a bit and making things a bit different every mission and every episode. Especially in the last few Soviet missions, I really wanted to, you know, provide something different by providing a bit of a historical context. Of course, just basically scraping the surface, and of course providing maps and, you know, graphics and stuff like that, you know, to make it more fun. I guess enlightening experience, educational experience. Overall, very positive one. So yeah, without you guys, this would have been... I wouldn't have really done that if I didn't really have anybody to comment on it. And this is not probably the last for Panzer General 2. There are certain scenarios, of course, that are still outstanding, still waiting me trying to actually tackle. I, you know, try a couple of different scenarios like Cauldron or something, but yeah, it's totally different. I mean, it's almost very specialized, and I need to see if I want to put those up outside of this LP series. Yeah, for now, Panzer General 2 has reached its conclusion and has run its course. Hope you enjoyed it. I will be back in some time, not too far from now, hopefully. If you are interested in the games of this ilk, just check back once in a while to see what kind of new things I have put up. I mainly want to focus on more classical kind of games rather than the new ones, although there are certain new games that kind of interest me right now. Well, until then, please check back once in a while, and thank you for watching this series.
Singing gaily, come at like on, he may give. There's no place like home.